is wrapping around the grain direction. So you'll know the grain direction by just doing that that test, okay? All right, so I'm gonna put that down. That's another way to test your paper, just in case you're not sure of the grain direction, all right? Okay, so I already know my direction and it's going up and down this way. So when I fold, I want to fold this way, okay? Now, we need to tear the paper into sections. So I know that my measurements of the bookboard, the width is about 6 inches, okay? So then I need to know, well, what's the width of my paper? How many leaves of paper can I tear in this one piece without wasting too much paper? So this paper, I believe, let's measure. I think it's around 25 inches. So there's 12, there's 24, and yeah, almost 25, about 24 and 3/4. Okay, so I have to think. I've got the width of my book is 6 inches, okay? So I need to tear a page or a piece of paper that is double the width of my book board, okay? And the reason for that is because your pages, the page I'm gonna be tearing out is not just a flat sheet of paper, it needs to be folded in half. So that's why I need to double that width. So the paper that I rip out, each leaf of paper, is going to have to be at least 12 inches. So I can do 12 inches twice with these, so that would be 24 inches. So I can get 2 leaves of paper that way through this width of my paper, and that's pretty good, okay? And then I need to take into account the height of my book board, okay? So which is almost 9 inches. And I believe this is 19 inches this way. So that's perfect because I can get 2 sections of 9-inch sheets right here, okay? So that's a great measurement. It's easy to take those sections out without wasting a lot of extra paper, okay? So even though I'm gonna be folding against the grain, I'm only doing that to tear my paper. So what I wanna do is divide this paper in half, okay? First. So I'm going to divide this paper by just folding it evenly, and I want my bone folder because it's going to help me create a really good crease. And now the reason for the bone folder is so they don't get dirt and oil onto the paper with your fingers, like you don't want to rub your thumb along it, it's going to put a lot of oil on the paper. Sometimes I have used my fingernails to make creases, and I don't think there's a problem with that, just make sure that your hands are clean, okay? So make sure everything lines up. The corners and the edges line up, okay? Kind of like origami. You want to make sure everything lines up before you start folding. Take it in the middle, take your bone folder, and run it down.
Cool.
Okay. And this is folding specifically for the purpose of tearing the paper, okay? So I actually do it in both directions because it kind of weakens the bond of the paper and it's easier to tear. So I fold it the other way.
And so you don't recommend cutting this with scissors at all?
It's not going to be exact if you cut with scissors.
Okay.
It's just not. It's going to be way more precise if you fold it in half.
Gotcha.
Yeah. I am going to use scissors though with the cover paper, mm-hmm. or the decorative paper that goes over your book board, just because it's easier to do it that way.
Okay.
All right, so I've got that folded pretty well, kind of weakening the paper a little bit so that it's easier to tear. Do it one more time. So if you are watching right now and you have any questions, please feel free to ask. It's a perfect time to ask, okay? Just use that chat option. Okay, so now I've got it folded and I can tear. So I'm gonna tear carefully. I'm gonna just start by making a tear there. Put my hand down here to kind of weight it down and then pull away from the tear. And some people, you can also buy tearing bars that you place. It's like a large ruler, but it's got weight to it, and you place it down, and then you tear against that tearing bar. So that's an option too. Okay. So I've got those two sections. Now I can put this one aside, and I'm going to work on folding it this way, because this is the, remember, this is the grain of my paper going up and down, okay? And I'm going to create the first two leaves of my book. And leaves are just the individual sheets, okay? And once you start folding them together, they're called signatures. Okay, so I'm going to divide that in half again like I did before, kind of pull away from the paper and press down with my bone folder. Okay. So I do the same thing again. I fold in half one way, open it, and then fold in half the other way just to